Although there have been individuals who have terrified the Jedi Order over the course of Star Wars history, there was one lightsaber, a weapon in fact, that chilled them to their core. But why was this? Why was a single saber enough to drive nearly the whole Order into an intense fear of the person that wielded it? And what exactly did this single lightsaber symbolize? This lightsaber would be something that would be passed down through the generations of Jedi as an evil Sith artifact, something that the Jedi Order would even quarantine, and that only Jedi Council members were ever allowed to see or even hold. But why did the Jedi Order have such an intense, long-lasting fear of this lightsaber? And who had the blade once belonged to? What's quite strange is this lightsaber originally began as a Jedi weapon, and a weapon developed by a Jedi Padawan. That Padawan's name was Exar Kun, a name that belonged to, at the time, a Jedi prodigy. But just like his lightsaber, one that one day would create intense fear among Jedi and the entire galaxy to add to that. The lightsaber of Exar Kun, even as a Jedi, was a very unique weapon. What made this lightsaber unique was the plasma that the weapon produced as a result of the Jedi crystal. Instead of the lightsaber color being a normal blue, it was more of a white blue, signifying that there was something wrong with Exar Kun's connection to the Force, something perhaps a little bit off. However, no member of the Jedi Order realized this at the time, claiming that the lightsaber was beautiful in coloration and unique. Exar Kun was in many ways a symbol of his lightsaber and a direct reflection of it. He was mysterious and powerful, an elegant lightsaber duelist, and considered at the time the most skilled lightsaber duelist perhaps of the entire Jedi Order during his era. Unfortunately though, because of this, his fame and notoriety went to Exar Kun's head as he began to view himself above others, specifically some of the species in the galaxy he was meant to protect as a Jedi. It became clear over the following years that it was Exar Kun's true pursuit not to protect the innocents of the galaxy, but to obtain as much power as possible. Unfortunately for Exar, though, the Sith during this era had all but completely died out. Fortunately, though, they had left much of their lore behind, including many Sith holocrons. It was because of this reason that Exar Kun departed the Jedi Order in search of Sith knowledge and Sith techniques. Exar did this in hopes of furthering his own power, but with the intent of not being corrupted fully to the dark side of the Force, as at the time it was not his goal to become a Sith Lord. However, eventually, Exar Kun would succumb to the dark side of the Force and symbolize his turn and ascension to the Dark Lord of the Sith with the creation and modification of his lightsaber. Within one of the oldest Sith holocrons that he could find, Exar Kun found the schematics of a new type of lightsaber that he had never seen before, a lightsaber with one hilt but two blades. Instantly, Exar Kun felt a connection to this design. He believed that it would give him a huge advantage over anyone in a lightsaber duel, and so Exar Kun went to work. Exar took his original lightsaber and modified it to adapt two blades, keeping his Jedi crystal, but doing something mysterious to it. Using dark side alchemy, Exar Kun poured the dark side of the Force within his lightsaber, making it extremely attached to the darkness, and thus why future Jedi, even being around it, risked corruption, and ultimately revealing why future Jedi would have to quarantine Exar Kun's lightsaber. When confronting the Jedi Order yet again, after becoming a Sith Lord himself, is when Exar Kun finally revealed his lightsaber to the wide universe. In a duel with his former master, Vodo Sias Boss, Exar Kun revealed that not only was his lightsaber modified, but it now had two blades. What made Exar Kun such a dangerous lightsaber duelist, though, is that the hilt was normal size. Exar Kun would actually change the blade length of each blade during a lightsaber duel, making him a master of the unorthodox, and a lightsaber duelist more akin to the likes of General Grievous or Darth Vader, someone who would lead a lightsaber duel with deception. Exar Kun was a pioneer of the double-bladed lightsaber. Not only was he considered the first true master of the weapon, but his blade was also unique, as we mentioned before, as the hilt was only standard size. What this meant is the normal major flaw of a double-bladed lightsaber was nullified, that flaw being that the hilt of a double-bladed lightsaber was far normal than a standard blade, and therefore was a bigger target, and most times, if the hilt was cut in half, one or both blades would deactivate permanently. Again, this being a flaw that Exar Kun completely nullified with his standard blade hilt. After Exar Kun's physical death, it became one of the Jedi Order's primary tasks to obtain this lightsaber, not to use it and learn from it themselves, but to hide it away so no one could ever find it. The Jedi Order deemed the weapon just that dangerous, and believed that the connection that it had to the dark side of the Force could form an even more powerful Sith Order if any Force user were to come into contact with the Blade. Centuries after Exar Kun's physical death, a member of the Jedi Covenant eventually would find Exar Kun's lightsaber, coming across the lightsaber seemingly by chance on Yavin 4. The Jedi Covenant being a group who was focused on eradicating all things Sith in origin. However, this Jedi feared what might happen if they attempted to destroy the lightsaber there. Therefore, they took it with them to the wider Jedi Order, in hopes of not using it, but in hopes of hiding it away so that no Jedi could ever come across it. Or heaven forbid, a Sith. This member of the Jedi Covenant took Exar Kun's lightsaber and encased it in some sort of special resin, a resin known as a nullification resin. This resin was designed to hold the evil dark side of the Force of any Sith artifact at bay and nullify it if ever so slightly. This was designed by the Jedi Covenant so that Sith artifacts could not call out to Force users to come find it. But this was not the end of the protection of Exar Kun's lightsaber, as after being coated in the resin, it had another place where it needed to enter. The Jedi Covenant then placed the blade of Exar Kun inside of what is known as the Sanctum of the Exalted, a place on the planet of Odrin that is considered extremely spiritual and light side oriented. Again, a place where the Jedi Covenant hoped that the lightsaber of Exar Kun would go to die, never to be seen or used again. However, this would not be the end of the most terrifying lightsaber in Star Wars history. One fateful day, a group of bounty hunters would enter this exalted place, taking several rare Sith artifacts, the lightsaber included. Unfortunately for the weapon of Exar Kun though, the bounty hunters had no connection to the Force, and thus it was made to sit and wait until it could find someone who did. When taking itinerary of the Sith artifacts, this is what was said about Exar Kun's lightsaber. I have a lightsaber. The Ithorians stole a nice looking specimen from the Jedi storehouse. I have taken it from them. The Jedi are truly a suspicious lot. The weapon is sealed in a special resin and labeled as some kind of evil artifact, dangerous to those using the Force. Even more than this, on the resin itself, the Jedi Covenant had written a warning. A warning that said that despite the weapon offering great power, it would also corrupt the user completely, and that the individual that had used it had been one so ingrained in the dark side of the Force that he still called out beyond death. Unfortunately for the bounty hunters though, they did not heed the warnings placed within the lightsaber, and unfortunately unwrapped the resin. Those that used it experienced a significant increased ability to use the Force, as they felt a surge through the dark side. However, they could also feel the weapon corrupting their very souls, and eventually it led to all of their deaths. Again, none of these bounty hunters had the ability to use the Force on a large level, but the lightsaber drove them insane. They simply did not have enough power to control the lightsaber and hold it at bay, and through their very hands, the lightsaber destroyed them all. Eventually, the Jedi Order would again discover the gruesome effects of Exar Kun's lightsaber, taking the weapon yet again, but instead gifting it to the Jedi High Council, as it was theorized only in the hands of the Jedi Council themselves would the weapon truly be nullified. Even the Jedi Covenant was not powerful enough to hold the weapon at bay. It is deep within the Jedi archives that the lightsaber of Exar Kun is rumored to still remain, a place deep within Coruscant that even the Jedi Council members may not be allowed to visit, with the Jedi Council hoping for all eternity that the weapon of Exar Kun never again sees the light of day and usage, marking this lightsaber as the most terrifying lightsaber the Jedi Order have ever encountered, and perhaps on its own, the most powerful lightsaber ever created. Beyond this though, the legacy of the lightsaber lives on, as the Sith themselves highly respect its design and its master. Darth Plagueis and Darth Sidious both had high praise for the lightsaber of Exar Kun, comparing it to the lightsaber design of Darth Maul. A saber staff, the weapon of Exar Kun. Did he construct that? The prototype was two lightsabers he had welded pommel to pommel, in imitation of the Iridonian Zaboka. I furnished the knowledge that allowed him to improve on the original design and construct the one he is using now. It strikes me as unnecessary, but I won't deny his mastery of the Jarkai technique. Nyman, the Taras Kaze, will never substitute for Dun Mok. but I appreciate that you have trained him as a fighting machine rather than a true apprentice. This little exchange between Darth Plagueis and Darth Sidious, where Plagueis was amazed that Darth Maul had created a weapon similar to that of Exar Kun, signifying his deep respect for the Sith Lord Exar. But that was the story of the most powerful and most feared lightsaber in Star Wars history, and how, even beyond the physical death of its master, the power of the lightsaber remained, permeating throughout the galaxy, and why this is one of the most feared items that the Jedi Order currently possess. Its ultimate fate, a complete mystery. But leave your own thoughts on this story in the comments down below. And did you know the legacy of the lightsaber of Exar Kun, and its huge implications on the Star Wars mythos, including what eventually happened to it being gifted to the Jedi High Council, and only the High Council? As always, my friends, thank you guys so much for watching. May the Force be with you, and have a great day. Before you go, be sure to check out my other channel, The Marvelous Wave, where we talk all about the Marvel Cinematic Universe, including news, breakdowns, and theories about all upcoming and past Marvel movies. Link to the channel is in the description below.